Hello and welcome to the show. I am back today on The Long Drive. It has been a little while actually since I have played this game, and I've kind of come back to it because we have, there's been an update. We have now got an American car. We've got the Plymouth Fury, the 50s, late 50s Fury is an option. Apparently it's quite rare and difficult to find. Some other things have been adjusted as well. Fuel and oil consumption is considerably higher. I'm not sure what other effects might happen while we're doing this. But yeah, we're going to see what we can do. We're going to aim to try and find a muscle car. Who knows? We're not likely to find it today, let's face it, but you never know. We can but hope, really, that we'll find something interesting. Right, stuff to sort out, stuff to say sort of like a beginning of the journey. Let's go and grab a basket. These things are always very, very useful. I'm gonna guess if the fuel consumption is up considerably, we might be a little bit sketchy for a while in this car. In terms of fuel, because you don't start off with very much at all. Can I get you to sit level, sort of? And I just don't know if it's phasing. I don't think it really matters if it's phasing through the flask. Oh, right, it'll do. Right, oil. We need to put you. What engine do you have? Okay, so we have got a two-stroke engine, which I don't really want, but that is what we have. We will get rid of that. I guess what I can do is fill this as much as I can. So we'll fill that, and then we'll use the oil to make it at the like 3% oil. That's fine. Like that there. That'll work, I guess. I mean, I guess that's kind of it. These air-cooled, I presume. There's nowhere to fill up there's no radiator, essentially, to fill up. So, I mean, I guess we'll take the water with us. Actually, we're going to need the water ourselves. Do we not have a... Oh, I know what I should probably put on. There are a whole load new options. Menu, that's the thing. I'll remember. Yeah, always show all of those so I know where we stand with the various bits and pieces. What I was going to say is, yeah, I might as well take this. We're not going to need the water necessarily for the car, but we have got this tap that we can sort of fill up this with, I hope. Right, so if we just go like that, and then that will do the job. I mean, I might as well, essentially, take as much water as I can from here. Somehow that's going into the... Yeah, it works. If it's close enough, you know, I'll take it. Alright, I'll turn that off. So, we've got a full carton of... full jerry can of water. That's good. Water is always important at the end of the day. So you can go in the boot. Now, we can take out the rear seat. Maybe we will at some point along the way. For now, I guess we don't really need to. That's full of a lot of oil. Don't really need to do that. We will, of course, have our BB gun. I mean, it's not the best weapon in the world. However, we know what those sneaky rabbits can be like. It's better than nothing. Right. Oil. Not taken very much out of this, but that's fine. We don't have very much fuel. Little I can really do about that here. We'll just have to hope that we can find some fairly quickly. So that can sit in there. I'll take the other jerry can, because you never know when you're going to need a jerry can, basically. I mean, this... This, as far as sort of starts go, I can't see there being much in the way of a difference here. We will take this with us, because we'll inevitably... Now, I could do this car up, however, I mean, I will plan on swapping out of it. My bigger concern, but the engine in this is garbage. Don't really like the two-stroke, horrible thing to work with, so I'm not really wanting to stay with that car for very long. So I'll bring this stuff. However, we will change. I guess we could. Actually, no, we can't swap a better engine into this car because there's no mounting for a radiator. So a good engine will just overheat anyway. So, yeah. I'll go have a look upstairs in case there is anything. I don't think anything fun ever spawns up here. Or particularly fun spawns. I say that, actually. We have another one of these, which is useful. I can go down there, and there was siphon. There's another sponge as well. Okay, it was definitely worth going up here. I can go down there. There is a sword. It's not really the... It looks cool. It's not really an effective weapon, as far as I am aware, at least. I guess it's not impossible it can do something, but I don't think it does much. There's a lot of clonking sounds going on. I can go in the boot. This can go in the boot. We'll probably should grab all the food. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Jeez! Nope! Go away! No one is here. Go away. Can you kill me through the window? I don't really want to find out. You know what? That is horrific. Oh, no! I don't like that. I think it's dead, I was just making sure. That's horrifying. It smashed whatever was in that bottle. I'm hoping it was nothing important. I'm going to guess it wasn't anything important. Jeez, okay. Have they got more vicious? Has that changed, or have I just never been attacked at the start line before with one of these? Maybe it's just a bit of bad luck. I'm going to have a look downstairs just in case anything interesting spawns here for us. A lot of alcohol. A lot of diesel that's of no use. A paint can for a yellow that we're not going to ever use. I mean, I guess that's kind of all we need to set off with. Some alcohol in there. Some alcohol. Food. That was what I was going in here before I got distracted by the cry of the rabbit. We might as well drink and fill up with the water that we've got here. Not quite sure how we're managing to drink from this bucket. However, it is working. Apparently, that's making us need to crap. Sure. Well, I've knocked that over. That's gone everywhere. I guess might as well eat the roll before we go. Anyway, this stuff does not give us much in the way of... So, I mean, the bacon... I mean, we know the sort of chorizo, whatever this is really good for food. So, definitely bring those along. You can hang them. However, I don't trust... I feel like the less calculations we can ask the physics to do, the better. So if that can sit in the physics-defying box, I'm going to be mostly happy. I wonder what was in there. Bloody rabbits. Oh, and we are going to want those as well, aren't we? So, we have got... I think we're about as set as we're going to be. I'm not very fussed about this car. I don't really want to keep this car for very long. Now, of course... Saying this means we're going to not find anything exciting ever, but let us begin the long drive. This has got BB pellets in the car immediately. Sweet. God, clatter, etc. going on. I think this may be the first time I've driven a two-stroke in a video, actually. A couple of off sort of test games I've played, off filming, etc. I have had a two-stroke engine in the past. They're terrible, pretty much. This is a thing that we are going to have for now. What on earth is this road? It is the wibbliest road for seemingly no reason. Sure. Is that the rev counter down there? I'm hoping it's revs and not temperature. Car does wander a little bit. Now, the tyres are probably crappy. We could fix them up. Okay, maybe I should grab some spares. But, yeah, we can fix the tyres up at some point. I think I just want to kind of get going. If we can get going, make some distance, see if we can find something better than this. If it suddenly goes pop and bang and then we're in trouble, we're in a lot of trouble. There is a boat over off to the left. Now, we won't find a car there. How far away from the road do we reckon that boat is? We won't find a car, but we could get a big barrel of fuel, which is always helpful. Especially considering fuel is a bigger concern. Let's go to the boat. I mean, that's a really helpful spawn. Let's face it, that's about as helpful a spawn as you can get in terms of stuff. Just give us a big old boat, filled to the brim with barrels of goodies. Fill our car full of oil and petrol, and like, you know, we'll be fine for a while, basically. Can't just pull around quite a lot. I'm not touching the steering at the moment, that's just where it's going. It wants to wander. Please, rabbits, do not attack me while I am scavenging the boat. Well, the brakes felt sharper. Where is the entrance? Is it down over? It must be over this side then. There it is. Perfect. Let's just drive straight. I like to just drive into this one. Normally, sweet. We've got an entire boat to ourselves now. All right, we can turn you off. I guess now might not be a bad idea. Let's just, out of curiosity, where should we start with? 2.6, I think, something like that. Sure. Did we not have a 5-door estate car? Have I not had a 5-door estate car? Don't see any need in keeping the sofa. You're full of gas. Ah, you're full of gas and oil, but also diesel. We don't want diesel. You're full of a mixture of crap. What on earth has gone on to have caused this? I mean, oil is... I don't need that much oil. Definitely don't need that much. Maybe I do need that much alcohol, to be fair. That might not be a terrible idea. It is a terrible... There's so much alcohol on this boat. That one's empty. If I just get a drum of petrol, I'll be happy with that. I guess maybe taking diesel isn't the worst idea in case I find a diesel vehicle. But I can't take everything, ultimately. That's what we want to see. We're surprisingly good at carrying this, because there is one of the heavier barrels. I mean, we can just do the cheesy kick it along route, whoop, and then put it back if it starts wandering off course. That's fine. Okay. Whoop. Yeah, we have more than enough petrol with that small, like, oil tub. I guess we could actually also, because we're currently running a 2-stroke... What if... Are you water? No, you're the empty one. Sweet. I don't want to carry a massive drum of oil because, well, that's just unwieldy. But what if we were to fill up a jerry can? See, I'm being prepared here. Fill up a jerry can. That's gas. That's actually helpful as well. But I've got a bigger tub of gas. Now I'm looking for oil. Game. What were you? Alcohol. What were you? Oh, I've made my mouse slightly too sensitive. That's why I'm having trouble to click on stuff. That one's empty. Where's this oil gone now? Now I can't find the bloody one I want. I swear it was all full of oil. What have you got? Come on, you're empty as well. I could use a siphon, but I don't think I need to. Okay, so if you... That will do. Now, keep an ear out for the cry of the lunatic rabbits. I don't really want to get eaten by them, if I'm honest. They are vicious buggers. In fact, this only had 19 litres, so it should fill the jerry can. Leave a little bit of space in that jerry can, so we should be good. I'm just going to keep looking this way, just in case. It gives me a chance if a rabbit decides to go and attack the boat. It gives me that little bit of a chance to shoot at it, panic and flail. I don't know if throwing a barrel at it would work. I get the feeling it probably wouldn't. But you never know. You never know. Yeah, this has been a very helpful start to us. We've got fuel, lots of gas that will probably do us well until we find another car, essentially. And it's just getting night. So we are going to have a snooze. Let's go have a rest. Awful, horrible, whatever storm sound that is can rage. Clatterbox is ready to go. There we are. We are off. Oh, we're a little bit hungry. Let's see if we can get to... See if we can get back to the road, actually, would be a good start. There it is. Over that way. Sure. Full speed ahead, please. It's not much, but it's better than nothing. Better than walking. It'd be a very long walk. I mean, it's a very long drive. So, the walking would be even worse. I hope there was a road over here somewhere. We might possibly be in trouble if there's not. I think I can see posts Just there we go. Yeah, that looks like posts. That looks like a building. Or is it? It's. Oh. It's not really very visible over there. It could just be a rock. Some of these do look kind of like buildings as you're barreling along. We're doing 100 kilometers an hour. Could be worse. The glare is terrible for this time of morning drive. There's the road. Okay, car, get ready. The brakes feel considerably sharper on this than I was expecting them to. Don't know whether that's something that's been changed. It definitely feels like it's actually getting stopped now rather than jump on the brakes and nothing happened for quite a while. The car's actually not that lightly loaded. It's got a big drum of fuel. It's got jerry cans full of various liquids. So, yeah, there is a building here at least. That's good. I was right. I was right about a building. What do you have? Not a fancy car for us. No, I just want a V8. V8 would be good. Hello, petrol station. We will let that turn off. Right, okay. What is that? Okay, yes, use another 0.2. Nothing crazy, though, so we're not doing terribly on... too bad on the fuel. What are you? Just a random girder? Anybody want a random piece of girder? It's not even that. Sure. Not the most useful. Don't need those either. Don't need anything out here. I mean, there's gold bars, but I can't do anything with them. There's a bumper for a car that's of no use. We can grab another jerry can of gas. What is in here? Alcohol. A lot of it. Again, just a lot of alcohol is going around. I mean, I guess we might as well fill the car up while we're here. You know, put it up to 4.4 litres. Better than nothing. And then we can give it just a little bit of oil. I'm immediately way more concerned about rabbits. And I probably shouldn't be, because I doubt there's much in the way of changing. I think I was just unlucky. Right, come on, game. I want to be able to see how much. There we go. That should do the job. Let's not drop this. Back in the boot of the car. Ish. Well, it's kind of close enough. Ooh, it'll have to do. Okay. No sign of any rabbits. Should have checked the roof. Not for rabbits, just the roof for loot. Although, probably should check the... You know, you don't want to get sneak attacked from the roof by one of the deathly rabbits. So it's probably a good idea to always check. That sounds really bad. Sounds really bad. But nothing is broken on the car, at least. So that's something. Okay. Rattlebox is away. Not much at the first building. I mean, we were always hoping to find... It's the big cafe kind of bits. They're the best ones because you're almost guaranteed to find a bigger. The workshops are kind of fun. They've got a lot of stuff in them. Whether that's what you want or not is anyone's guess, but they're normally full of stuff. At least parts for the car and that sort of thing. I think I have found one that had a shell of a car and nothing else in it. That was kind of fun. Sort of having to build... I say, or you could choose to try and build something like that from scratch. If I found a vehicle with a place for a radiator, I might be tempted. Don't know whether I could shove this engine in it. Whether it would work, that's a good question. If I shove the two-stroke in it, still put fuel and oil in it and run it, whether the game would allow that to... I guess those cars wouldn't have cooling for an air-cooled engine. Possible. I guess might would kill it. I mean, we're pondering problems that we're possibly not going to have. There is definitely something over there, though. Is that a workshop? Well, it looks like a hangar from this far back, but I don't think that is a building in the game. I mean, we're on the quest for this muscle car. I'd really love to get the hold of the muscle car. However, if we find one of the pickup trucks, that would also be perfectly acceptable. As I was looking for one of those before, and we never got it. Is that a truck or a bus on the back of it? It's a long way away. If it is a building, brakes definitely feel a lot better. No, I think that's a watchtower and that's the rock. Now, watchtowers can have guns in, which are helpful to have because, well, actual guns are better for dealing with rabbits than a BB gun. But I'm not going all the way over there for a watchtower on the off chance. It might have a gun. It's not worth my time, so we shall stick to the road. Damn it. So much for this long-range building spotting. I mean, it did... To be fair, it didn't look like a building. With the way the shape of that rock from a distance, the very top of that rock formation does kind of look like a building. Damn it. Chance for hopefully a better car. It's certainly not the best driving. It does, as I said, brakes are good. The handling, when it's not wandering around, I've driven worse on this game. When you put the massive tyres on them, they drive a lot worse, funnily enough. Who would have thought? Or some of the ridiculous trailers. I've got to guess this would not pull trailers very well. Don't think the engine is all that fast. That is a rock? The hell is that? No, it's just like a rock formation-y kind of thing. God, it's very weird. It looked like almost like a forest, and there's that. No, that's not. We're not in the right biome, and even then, we don't actually get trees. The sort of grassy biome is just grass, which is coming up on our. I think actually heading towards it on our right-hand side. Oh dear, game! Don't even think about it. I mean, I know we've got some jank going on. I'm trying to get. I say we're barreling along at 100 kilometers an hour. Problems have gone on. Trying to catch it. Can't catch it. That was uncalled for. That was very uncalled for, car. It's just like it's one of those spins. I could sense it happening. I could feel the car was about to go, and there was just I was trying everything I could to get it back under control. It just wasn't going to be enough. It starts wiggling, and then it's just too late. I can't reel it back in. We just have to accept the fact that we're going to crash, and there's not very much I can do about it. Like, we do need some food. Now, as I said, the Trizzo is great. Now, that stuff will, whatever it is, that stuff will fill you up pretty quickly. Actually, please let there be a building over this crest. Really, really helpful if there was. I say it'd be really helpful. I mean, we're not too terribly off. At some point, the engine will probably cut out because it'll run out of fuel. We can deal with that. We're not heading all the way into the grassy area. It's like the path curves off. That just looks... That's a boat over on our right-hand side. It's difficult to look and drive, but over there, that's a boat. As we were just flicking along, I could have sworn it was just like a giant low-pixel sheep. I know it sounds dumb, but... Yeah, well, from the distance, we can't really tell what it is. It could be a sheep. Another boat. What has gone on here? We've found all the boats in the world. Yeah, there's one over there as well. There is something in terms of a building along this road I just saw. I think it's just a bus stop, though. Down there? What is that? It's a long way away, whatever it is. Maybe it's a bit bigger than a bus stop. Incredibly difficult to tell. We are now flying along at 105 kilometres an hour. It's hardly record-breaking pace. We can't even get off the bloody speedo at this point. Definitely something there. Could that be a workshop? Well, please let it be a workshop. Please let it be a workshop with a half-fixed Fury, because that would be fun. I would be totally up for trying to get one of those, like to try and scavenge the parts that we could from this and whatever is at the workshop, try and make it run. Would be an entertaining way to go. Doesn't look like a workshop, but we'll have to wait and see. The boat, I feel like we're okay at the moment. I guess if we desperately need something, we can head up there. Got to keep an eye on all of the gauges. If we can just get to the house, which we should be able to do, I don't see any reason why not. I say that as the vehicle is wandering around all over the road. Get to whatever that is. No, it's not a workshop. It's one of the small huts. Damn it. Would have been too easy. Oh, that's bad news. Whoa. Thought we were going to be fine to go over that. Boy, was I wrong! I haven't actually lost a wheel off my car, though. That's the important thing. Oh, there is a car down there! Sweet! Okay, we haven't lost anything too bad out of this one. Oh, okay, we did nearly lose a very important meal. We know how important this is. That would have been an absolute catastrophe. Because we would have been completely out of food as well had that gone pinged somewhere way worse. This thing is full of fuel. Come on. In we go. Yes, that's the ticket. Nicely done. Can't see any rabbits. We'll chase them off with the not a snake if we get desperate. Not sure it's going to work somehow. But it's, you know, in an emergency, we might just need it. Alright, and a whole bundle of water. That is very helpful. I think we've recovered everything. Yeah, that rock. I thought we were going to be high enough. I thought we would be able to clear it. I was completely wrong, sadly. We just hit, I don't know, underside of the car, hit side of the car. Whatever hit was enough to upset the physics and just launch us skyward. The car does look like a fairly mundane, boring one. Over here, that definitely doesn't look like a Fury, which is a shame. It's just a frame of a car as well, isn't it? There's nothing else to it. Hmm, indeed. Well, there's a bike. Let's have a look. Let's have a little poke around. Bugger me. I mean, it really is. There's nothing on it. Oh, that's a shame. It would have been perfect. Would have been absolutely perfect to swap two ways. Is it one of the rear engine cars? I think it is, actually. I mean, slightly less perfect. Can I... out of curiosity. Whoopsie. Can you? Surely you couldn't. It doesn't have a fuel tank? Where do you fill it up? Don't know how to fill it up. I was wondering whether you could run the car on a bike engine. I mean, I feel like that's almost a possible thing that you could do. Not a very good one, but it could work. There's various body panels around for a car. A random bed in here? Sure. You know what? That's fine. Oh, let's get us some nice red glasses. Okay, I take it back. Oh, dear. How do I get rid of the glasses? I thought they would be fun. But I've made a terrible, terrible mistake. Is there a way to remove them? I don't know. That's not the way to remove it, but I do need to evacuate my bowels at some point. There we go. We'll just press the button until we have made an awful amount of noise. There we go. We feel better now. And then we can probably just pee off the roof. That works for me. Yeah, I don't know how to get rid of the sunglasses. I don't really want to drive continually with the kind of reddy tinge. I thought it was fun and novel. I didn't actually realise. I swear I've picked up the sunglasses before and they didn't mess around like this. I could be wrong. Sorry, I should pick a yawn. it's incredibly professional, I know. I could be wrong on that. But yeah. Oh, I've been driving along with that open. Whoops. Probably close that. Probably be a good idea, really. I will nick that basket, though. It's a shame there's nothing on that car. I like the idea of having to, like, scavenge for parts and try and make something work. However, when there's literally nothing, I don't think it's quite going to work somehow. I know why I can't fill this up, because the bike engine requires... I mean, this bit here for the fuel tank. Whereas the air-cooled engines like this one, the fuel tank is all part of it. So this car doesn't have a way to refill itself because it's expecting to have the engine be the way to go. And while it is tempting to go with this, I'm not going to swap over to that car. It is tempting in some ways to try and pilfer stuff, but we're just not going to be improving our own vehicle, really, with that decision. What do you come from? I think that's just bugs. I got a little bit scared. I think also, as people said, you can drink. It's not much, but that could keep you going. could keep you alive if you're desperate, I guess. Not that we'd actually need to, because we can drink out of the tap in the kind of bathroom area here. Well, we've got another crate for the roof. That's always a bonus. Yeah, we found this sort of junkyard of cars, and, well, a bike. Sadly, no Plymouth. It will be a while until we find, potentially be a while. It's supposed to be quite a rare car, I think, from what I've read at least. So, yeah, we may well continue the adventure looking for either a pickup truck or the new Plymouth. See if we can keep our vehicles running. And we almost got killed by a rabbit before we even left the garage. It's a solid start, really. But there we go. That is going to be it for this video. Thank you all very much for watching. And until next time, a goodbye.